Hello everyone, and welcome back to Rediscovery. So, it seems I'm actually starting to run out of things to do in this series, or it's only a few goals left. In this episode, I want to head to one of those goals, the End Isles, because there's a lot of stuff to do in the end now, and I never done any of it. So, there are a few things to go over real quick. You might notice some things look a little different around here, because, one, I have changed the beacon's color. I decided gray didn't look good and decided to do with teal, because, you know, I had the teal on the banner too, so I thought that was a good color to go with, and, or cyan, I think it technically is. And I think it looks much better if it does kind of blend a bit more with the sky, but it's good. Also, I have been, getting blocks, and I think I'm only 30 blocks away from finishing the beacon, so that's kind of exciting. Aside from that, I have improved some things around the base. I did go around and add the stairs around the entire base, and also did some slabs by the window so they look a bit better. So, I don't know. Hopefully that looks a bit nicer. I'm just not sure how else to stylize this. You know, I think I did remove the pillars and was going to do pillars here on the outside, maybe. I don't know. I still need to do more of the house here, but it's coming along. I also did revise the torches and put them on acacia fences because I thought that looked nicer. I thought the orange would be nice anyway. And aside from that, I did something else. Oh yeah, the bridge. I finished the bridge out here, so I wanted to show you guys that real quick. So this is the kind of thing I was going for. So I have it going down, and I have it kind of arcing up and then over. So if I go on the bridge, you know, it's pretty much just a bridge. I don't know, I kind of think I might want to diverse the wood a bit, especially the supports probably could be a different color. And look a bit more supporty, but I didn't like the birch. I don't like the birch logs because I don't feel they look as good as like oak logs or such when doing support. So I don't know, that it is what it is. And there is one other thing I did with the base, so show that real quick. But aside from that, I am pretty well prepared for the End Isles, I think. Or at least I did talk to Akatori before recording, and he said I probably should get more blocks. But I think aside from that, I'm good. Well, I did talk way back when I first made the base about having a dock. So I have a little path down here to dock and boats of varying colors. So, I don't know, and that's really not needed now. And I also did plant some trees in there in the dead space, because one, I need to get more, I think, birch for the bridge over there. So I had a whole bunch of birch trees, and I was like, you know what, let's just put some trees there to help fill the space. So, I don't know, I think this place is coming along nicely, and I'm not sure how much will change by the end of the series, considering there's only 5 or less episodes left. I'm not sure if I'm even going to get the full 5 in now. But let me just grab another steak so I can eat and still have half a steak or half a thing of steaks. Put that back and grab some cobblestone. So there were a few other things. Oh, one thing kind of cool. Remember how they had the music disc off a creeper? I managed to do it again, which was really awesome. So I think when I was mining or just in a cave, I did manage to do that. I also did turn the mine shaft into a strip mine, or I continued down from the mine shaft and made a strip mine so I don't have to go to spawn or other places to mine. And, oh, it's not in here. I thought I did have it in here. I did enchant a diamond shovel because I realized, you know, I have enchanted tools now, or at the point where I should have enchanted tools, so why don't I have diamond tools? I don't know, I do really need to sort out the pickaxes. The reason I have this pickaxe, ideally I'd want an efficiency 5 diamond one. I just didn't have any ready, because my other efficiency here is too degraded. That's too degraded, and I didn't really want to repair them. So I was like, I guess I'll just grab the other fortune one. So, I don't know, I need to sort that out. The problem is, this costs a lot of levels to repair now, like 35 to repair it fully. And I don't have that many levels, so I need to look into mending or other solutions, maybe getting a new prosperity. Because the problem with the tools is they do keep increasing repair costs indefinitely now, to the point they get too expensive. So, that's unfortunate. But, yeah, what Akatori said, though, is I probably would need more blocks, so I'm just gonna grab another few stacks of cobblestone. And I think I'm still gonna leave a few inventories. Yeah, I think that is enough cobblestone, hopefully. So, one inventory space free. But from what he mentioned, I think we will have to be building around the end islands a good bit, like between them. Hopefully there's not much that will knock me into the void. That is my biggest fear with this, because we still do have the woodland mansion. Actually, let me just hold off on that. But yeah, still have the woodland mansion, and you know, there isn't too much more to do in the end though. So yeah. And I think I'm just going to cut till I get to the fortress to save the Netherport transition and the long minecart ride actually into the end. Because I did do a few things there. I forgot I even mentioned it last episode, but I did a few things there. Okay, so here we are at the end. I built an endstone pathway up here because, well, the portal areas kind of out there. Also, yeah, didn't delete any of the pathway. If I just walked off the obsidian into the void because it deleted, like, the end stone near it, that would be awkward. So, I might need more end pearls for this. I don't know. But, yeah, I didn't. But, yeah, this is pretty much the end. I haven't done too much else besides the stuff over here. So, you remember after I defeated the dragon, there was a little thing off in the distance. Well, I kind of built up to it because I do not trust my ender pearl skills. And I think I also would like to grab a few more ender pearls real quick. Speaking of ender pearls. But I can. Ow. Yeah, I don't know. I hope this is enough. It probably isn't, but I hope it is. I think in the end, islands there will be endermen, and I can do the same kind of trick there if I need to. Hopefully. But yeah, I was going to just build a platform under it, but then I realized the fall damage would probably kill me. And I decided just to build up to it, because yeah, you saw it did the little beacon thing. I'm not sure what triggers that, maybe just proximity. But you need to throw an enderpearl in there to get to the end islands. And if I missed and hit the bottom, I'd fall into void. So I really hope this is good enough. And yeah, I've never been to the end islands. I have no idea what to expect besides, you know, the things I've seen. Shulkers I know are there. You know, the end ships, the end cities. So, yeah. Oh, that was a pretty quick transition. And there we go. So here's our way back home. Also, I put the stuff behind it just in case I somehow missed and I went past the portal. If a pearl just falls into void, I think that's... Also, why did I even bring torches? I don't know. Well... There we go. So, I'm not really sure what to expect here. There's a lot of Endermen. That seems good. There's these chorus plants, but I don't really have the inventory for them yet. I know you can get fruit and grow them and smelt them into purple blocks, I think it is. Or something like that. The popped chorus fruit that makes purple blocks, which is the stuff the cities are made of. And I see what Akatori meant about needing blocks. So, you know... There's nothing here, and I need to go to another end island. But if I miss an ender pearl and fall into void, oh my god, that would be so embarrassing. So, I think I'm just going to try and build a path, and hopefully we can find one of the structures, because there's the end cities, and then there's a rare chance for an end city to have an end ship. The end ship's what I really want to get, because that's where the elytra is, and that's one of the things I want to get. But the end cities themselves, not just the end ships, have some stuff I need, I think. So, let me just look around. I'm so glad not to be building over void now. I took off my shield to help with the building. And rearranged this because I want ender pearls and a pickaxe here. Probably should have done that in retrospect. Anyway. I really hope what I'm looking for is here or nearby so I don't have to keep bridging between these islands because it's kind of nerve-wracking building over void. Not gonna lie. Also, I could just harvest endstone if I run low on blocks. Akatori didn't mention that. Or I kind of figured I could, but... Yeah. Also, I probably should... I don't know. I know there are other portals back, but I probably should just light a bit. And I feel like this is a... Yep, that's a fall into void. I'm just worried that there is some mob I don't know about that could attack me. Or an Enderman will just decide to push me off for no apparent reason. Making sure I'm not accidentally jumping off the edge. So, I don't know, this place is interesting. It seems a bit barren. I kind of wish there was a better way to traverse this, or I don't know, it's just always void is kind of scary, because if you fall into void, all your items are gone, and I really don't want to get back this armor. Or the other stuff. Especially the armor. And probably also the bow. But I don't know, this seems like a much bigger area to explore. There's just all those little islands, and with the purple block structures here, it's hard to see. Like, if a city's there, kind of like, you know, it's kind of like a forest, the end equivalent of a forest, so it's hard to know if there's stuff behind it or not. Like, there could be a building back there, and I'm just not seeing it this far away. At the moment, I'm not seeing any obvious buildings or portals back. I know they're supposed to spawn around the end now in 1.11 and not just the original one you came from to make it easier to get back. But, retrospect, I probably shouldn't leave these torches because I'm trying to find my way back. They could lead me the wrong way. You know, it kind of just goes to a dead end, more or less. So, I don't know. I think I am just going to cut till I find something or something happens. Hopefully nothing happens, because that kind of entails falling to the void, dying, or something else catastrophic. But, yeah, I'll just have to look around, because I'm not really sure what else to do here or what else to say besides just set up looking for the city. Still looking for the city, and wow, I've been losing a lot of hunger sprinting. Probably should have brought more food in retrospect. That might be a problem, but I do have the gold foods there too. Actually, I think I'm gonna do something a bit more risky and enderpearl for the first time. Well, second time, technically. Okay, the only thing I was worried about is ender mites, because I know they're a thing. So I want to put some torches here, just so I know... Oh, there is a land bridge here. I thought I had Ender Pearl again, just so I know the way back. But I don't know, let's just look over here, and if I can't see anything over here, like the end city stuff, then... Wow, that enderman looks weird. Just the two endermen on top of each other. But yeah, if there's nothing over here end city-like, I think that's just another big island with the small ones. Well, end ore generation is going to be a bigger thing now. Well, I know that's always been a thing in the past. There haven't been too many mods that done stuff at the end to a large degree anyway. I know there's Hardcore Ender Expansion and Draconic Evolution, although I never used Draconic much. Looks like I might need to progress to another island, so... Yeah, anyway, I think I'm just going to cut now and see if I can find the end cities. Oh, I see it there. That's an end ship too, isn't it? Okay, so I just see the silhouette in the distance, but that definitely looks like an end ship. I think I got lucky because I know not all the end cities even have end ships. Oh god, this might be great then. Yeah, that definitely looks like an end ship. Whew, I was worried I wasn't even going to find one of these. So, that's the end city. As I'm getting closer, we can see more of it, and there is an end ship with it. The problem is now, well... I didn't leave a very good marker. I guess I'll just do that to kind of point the way back. Still haven't seen another portal back. I don't know, maybe I haven't. I've just been missing it. Well, the problem now is I think I need to bridge across this because I do not trust my Ender Pearl skills enough to make sure I'm going to clear that gap. And yeah, it'd be really trashing now just laying on the side and just go, woo. So yeah, we'll have to go to the end city and I guess we'll have to go through the tower to the ship. I don't know, I haven't done this before, but... I probably could build up the ship, but I'm afraid there might be mobs about to knock me off a pillar. So, yeah. Anyway, give me like 2 hours to pillar over and, yeah. Okay. I think we're good. Yep, we made it. Whew. My hands are sweating a bit. I'm not sure if it's because that's a bit nerve-wracking, or because it's hot in my room, or both. The heater's on because it's cold outside. It actually snowed recently, so yeah, it's like under 20 degrees Fahrenheit. So yeah, pretty cold, at least for around here. Yeah, that's also why my sinus might be a bit stuffy or has been a bit off. I know it's probably not the best thing to talk about, but you know, you might notice in my voice. I don't know, probably not that noticeable. Also, I did get some more ender pearls back on the other island, because, yeah, they're important. So, here is the end city. I don't know where the end... There they are! Okay. Huh, that does work. Okay, so I killed two shulkers. Now, one, I didn't know if the shield would even block, but I got the shulker shells, and that's why I have a crafting table and chests. So I know you can dye these, I'm not sure how, but if you go like this, a shulker box. The first time I'm actually making one of these in survival, I used them in before though, but I can open this to store stuff. Like all this cobblestone, because I don't need all this cobblestone, and some ender pearls. And the chest too, why not? I probably want to keep most of this other stuff. I have the milk with me, by the way, to negate the levitation effect, because if those bullets hit me, I'd start levitating upwards, which could get me killed in some situations. Now, the other thing I want to do now that I have a shulker box is break one of those and see what I get. Okay, so you get this, and I think I'm just going to harvest some and put in the shulker box. Okay, but oh, I never really explained what shulker boxes are. I just kind of assumed you knew. Yeah, I can break it, and... Ta-da, it keeps the content. So it's the Minecraft version of a backpack, or the vanilla version of a modded backpack, which I think is really cool. I actually was also mentioning to Akatori earlier how I'm glad the shulker boxes are not just backpacks in a sense. Like, I kind of wish there was still an earlier game backpack, because this is pretty late game. It's kind of past the point where a backpack's super useful. Still useful, though. But, you know, it would have been helpful earlier on. But at the same time, it is really cool that Vanilla did this for a backpack instead of just copying a backpack mod, you know, just turn leather into a backpack and it holds items sort of thing. That would have been a bit more lame in my opinion. Or more so, after waiting so long for Vanilla Backpack, I feel like that would just be a lame way to go about it. And actually having it, you know, something dyeable, something more interesting. Also, these end rods. Mine. Yeah, I got it. So these emit light and they look cool. And there's also apparently the end bricks here and that stuff. I don't know. I'll harvest some of them, but so from what I know, well, as we go up, there's going to be more shulkers. The shulkers will levitate us up. We haven't got to like the main. Yeah, this part. It's like parkour kind of thing, and you go up. Sorry. That looked like a block there with possibly a chest or something underneath. So yeah, it's supposed to kind of parkour. Now I'll probably have to use some handy dandy building cobble to help me out here because I'm not really good at parkour. Oh wow, that's gonna get annoying placing it the block below. But yeah, if I do this, I can make a nice little staircase up. But as we go up this, there will be shulkers. They'll try and levitate you up and disorient you in that respect. And I know that because I saw the stuff. Oh god. Well, so at the moment it's kind of helpful. Huh. So I think shulkers are immune to damage until they do that. Ah. You see now why I have the milk. Also, that's a really weird noise. I don't even think I can progress forward. Okay, so apparently that was the end of this section, and you kind of have to go over to the sides. I have levitation for a few more seconds. So, there we go. Whew. So yeah, that levitation effect, it can be helpful or hurtful depending on where you are. And there's another shulker there, so... Okay, I think I'm going to have to try and charge it when it opens... Uh-oh. Well, this is not good. I don't know what happens if I end a pro with levitation, so I think I'm going to chance it. Ow. Okay, that did not deal as much damage as I thought it would. Oh, so it can still damage them when they're not open. Good to know. Oh, and they have end banners too. I don't know where the other shulker came from, though. And is there anything here? Nope. Okay, so far we got a good bit of shulker box components. I feel like there was another shulker, or it was just a missile from earlier that looped back around. That could be it too. I don't know. It is kind of weird or interesting how the missiles do kind of loop around like that. Oh, I can shoot them! I had no idea I could do that, actually. Whew! Okay, that makes it more interesting. There's more stuff here. Uh-oh, this is the room I was thinking of. Well, good news, they don't deal much damage. Oh boy. Uh-oh. Ooh. So I think I kind of cleared this floor, and there is loot in here too. Well, I got Silk Touch. And there is an ender chest, and surprisingly, I don't think I ever made an ender chest in the series. I also think I was leaning towards the mic, so sorry if I was loud or anything. Usual kind of apologies. I think that's a good idea. I could just put stuff in the ender chest I want to kind of send back because I don't have anything in there. And if I do die... So I think I'm going to leave this ender chest here for the moment and just kind of throw some junk in to send back or some stuff I'm currently not using, not necessarily junk. And there is also that shulker shell way down there. And I kind of want to go get it. Just because I think you kind of... They shot it out of the tower and around it. I saw it outside the window there. That's a little concerning. I also want to get these end rods because they look really cool. Yeah. I don't know where they are. If they're actually outside the tower. Because I'm not going out there. I mean, it probably wouldn't be too bad. Yeah, just... I feel like they're on the side. Like, up this ladder on the side or... I don't know where they are. Yeah, they could be anywhere around here, really. I can't say. And the fact I can't say where they're from is kind of terrifying. But I do know there's probably going to be more as we ascend this, and I'm not sure there's going to be more loot at the top or what, but, well, this episode is about exploring the End Islands, so I kind of need to explore the End Islands and go up here, or explore at least this End City completely. That's kind of my goal. I know there's the other place to decide, too. And, yeah, so let's see... So far, I haven't seen any shulkers. Oh, that one got me. So I feel like it's kind of... modularly generated, is that the right word? So, like, this could have been leading somewhere, but it isn't just because of how it generated. Who? Uh-oh. Well, I guess I might as well levitate on up while I'm at it. Oh, Enderman. Yeah, that's the first time I think I've seen an Enderman in the End City. Uh-oh. Okay, so... keep on up, or keep on going up. I just don't know where they're coming from. I feel like they're coming from outside, like... well, here. Actually, you know what? Just for safety, I'm gonna do that. And I think I wanna go all the way up the tower before I head out here. Cause I feel like, yep, one's shooting me. Actually, can I hit him with my sword too? I should really test that. Yeah, shulkers are really interesting. Oh, I can get it from here. There we go. Now, I know I'm not getting as many shulker shells because I should use the looting on my sword. But at the same time, this is dangerous. That's really all I have to say about that. It's dangerous. Okay, there was nothing else up here besides the one shulker. Might have been using the window there to shoot out. Probably don't want to jump all the way down there. I don't think it dropped the shulker shell anyway. Okay, so over here, I have no idea what we have. Oh, this kind of leads towards the End City, but that one's going to be closer. So I guess we cleared this whole tower? I think I got all the sides of it anyway. I don't know, this place is kind of confusing in how it loops around, or I don't really have a good mental image of it right now. Yeah, so we went over here to this side, which led back into the middle. Oh. Okay, so we went up the middle. And yeah, I think there are more shulkers on the outside. But I really don't want to go out and get them. I have enough shulker boxes for the moment. Thank you very much. So yeah, this was the center. Okay, I think I can look better from here. So it led back up here, which wasn't actually the same as this. This led over to nothing. And that's the final one that leads to the ship. Whew. Ow. And that's how you fall down. And that's also how you fall down. So, well, while I'm here, I think I'm going to end off the episode here. It might be a bit short due to all the cuts, but I think I want to save the end ship for the next episode and the other side of the tower. So hopefully we can get the Elytra and some better loot. I know you can get good loot here, like enchanted diamond stuff, I think. And this is also where you can get items with mending on them naturally. Also the curses, I think. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see what we find. So yeah, anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, and until next time, goodbye.